On to the next. Signal, and now, the writer.
Previously on Alan Wake.
It's not a lake. It's an ocean.
After saving my wife from the mysterious dark presence, I found myself trapped in the dark place.
Imagination can be the enemy here.
A nightmarish world that exists somewhere beyond the shores of our own existence.
We're the one making all this happen.
Just do what Zane tells you.
Follow the signal.
Is all this really coming out of my head?
The dark place is playing tricks on you.
I made my way across its ever-shifting landscape, trying to reach Thomas Zane.
You're trapped in your own nightmares. You're still going deeper.
Yo, Mustard OG, thank you for the nice resub. That was a nice resub.
It's all in your head. You've been making it up.
Really, Wake? Really?
Your
delusions are out of control.
Get out of my head.
Seriously, Al, you need to get a grip. You know reality's different here. See what I mean?
Ugh, I think I'm stuck on this side.
Well, you're gonna have to find your way out of there. I'll wait. Just remember, you're still in the dark place. You know that, right? I don't want to alarm you, pal, but it's sink or swim time.
Fine.
I don't have a flashlight.
I could feel the pressure mounting. Barry was right. Time was running out. Everything I saw was a dark, twisted version of reality based on my memories and thoughts.
I want to shut it on the crumble, right? But that's as far as I can get it.
I think you gotta swing it!
Accept it. If all of this was from my mind, then I was the one making all this happen. I was literally fighting myself. It was a moment of clarity.
Yeah, I know. Surprise! Oh no. What hit it? Oh, the lantern? Okay.
After finishing departure, I felt finished myself. All I had wanted was to save Alice. After that, a part of me had been ready to just give in and die. But I hadn't given up. Thomas Zane had reached me. I had run across a nightmarish landscape following a signal from him. He kept telling me I was sinking, going too deep. I wasn't sure if he meant the dark place or insanity. Perhaps they were one and the same.
Oh. Oh, pump action shotgun. I was like, pump? What do you mean by pump? Like a tire pump?
Hey, nice job, Al! So, you really are nuts, huh? Let's face it, we always knew this was coming.
I guess, but I actually feel pretty rational, all things considered.
Crazy people don't know they're crazy. That's where they're crazy. Hey, check out the light show behind the lodge.
That's Zane's light.
Yeah, you're done sinking now. That means he's just about caught up with you. You better go talk to him.
Oh, it's Amityville. We're fucked. Yeah!
Fireworks here.
Woo!
Nice!
Wake heard the old gods play. Music came out all wrong.
Time to rock and roll!
It's rocking the horrors!
Oh, hell yeah! Remember this, Al?
Oh my god! Stun locking is so fucking stupid!
Nice!
Wake heard the old gods play. Music came out all wrong. It attracted the horrors!
Oh, hell yeah! Remember this, Al?
Oh my god! I don't have any flares. That was last
Lots
time.
Lots of fireworks here. Nice!
Wake heard the old gods play. Music came out all wrong. It attracted the horrors!
Oh, hell yeah! Remember this, Al?
Oh, I didn't pick up the revolver this time. Oh, good.
Lots of fireworks here. Nice!
Wake heard the old gods play. Music came out all wrong. It attracted the horrors!
Oh,
Remember this, Al?
Oh my god.
Lots of fireworks here. Nice.
Wake heard the old gods play. Music came out of the It attracted the horrors.
It is fucking annoying. It's really annoying.
Oh, hell yeah. Remember this, Al?
What the fuck? Are you kidding me?
Living passing moment, more of them came!
Hey, isn't it kind of ironic that you're a writer and you're threatened by your own imagination? It's like your greatest power turned against you!
That's very deep, but I'm a little busy not dying over here.
Jeez, always with the melodrama.
Surrounded by the enemies and deafened by the noise, Wake was helpless.
You. Much easier that way.
You can get inside now, Al.
Shut up, idiot! I know! Fuck you!
See, Al? This is classic you. Always making things complicated.
This is just a memory.
Even your memories are complicated.
Oh! Well, goddammit!
Yeah. So, I guess you're gonna leave it all to Zane out there now that he's actually here. I'm just gonna, you know, let you non-imaginary people talk in peace.
You're not coming?
Nah. That was a crutch, you know. Hey, you're moving up in the world, buddy.
Zane.
You have done well, Alan. Now I can accompany you. You are trapped in your own dream. You must wake yourself up, but first, you have to reach yourself.
The cabin.
Yes, my cabin. It will not be easy. Your previous work can help you. I still have some pages of your manuscript left. Words like that have power here.
Guys, the lighthouse.
The lighthouse?
It's very appropriate. I can help you reach it. But after that, you will be on your own. I cannot enter the cabin now. The Dark Presence made sure of that on our last encounter. You are facing yourself, the parts of your mind that are hard to control. This is not a fight anyone else can win for you.
He said it, control!
Oh, okay.
I was glad to have Zane with me in this place. He knew the terrain, such as it was, but a part of me wondered if he was even human anymore, after so many years in this place.
The world was tilted! It was turning upside down! Wake was lost! He would fall! He couldn't tell which way was up! He would die there, torn apart by the whirlwind!
Uh-oh. Auntie M. Just jump through the window!
Wake was too high. Too high! At this height, the water would be like...
Wake was too damn high!
You can't want me dead this bad.
The storm was coming! It would throw him off!
That was a good placement. Come on, dude. Damn it. Damn you.
The storm spun him around. It was made of darkness. He'd seen what it could do. It swept everything away.
I would have to make my way through the swirling madness. It reminded me of the dark presence, just another memory, but it could still kill me.
No! In the swirling madness! Oh my god, press the button! I pressed the fucking jump button! The controls are fucking me! This is not a platformer! That's for fucking sure!
Stay focused on the lighthouse. If you can reach it, you will find the cabin.
Things are getting pretty crazy here, Zane.
It's to be expected. You are struggling to reclaim yourself. The landscape reflects that strain, but each step takes you closer. If you persevere, you can attain the lucidity that fends off the darkness.
Okay.
Now that I knew what I was facing, the environment became even wilder and stranger. Like it was no longer even bothering to pretend that things were normal.
You got to roll, roll, roll. You got to thrill my soul. Well, all right. That'll work. Oh. The fuck? Am I not supposed to go down here?
Ah, there we go.
That's a pretty neat mechanic. I'm not mad at that. That's pretty cool. Oh yeah, give me all the pennies from heaven.
Just like a turd.
Y'all.
Wait. Mike was forced to run through a maze, hopelessly sprinting in the wheel, never getting anywhere. His life in miniature, it was useless.
Damn it. Hey,
whoa,
Lantern Lady!
Now what?
Oh, I guess I was supposed to do that. What the fuck?
Mr. Wake, can I help you with anything?
Let's have a look at your head, Mr. Wake.
Please! God damn it, I said please! I need more light!
Oh, I gotta wait for them. Okay. Whoa, I could have got soft locked there, I just realized. Making my stomach a little queasy. Oh shit. Damn it! I'm fine. Everything's fine. Thank you. Really beautiful design, though. Honestly, this is really cool. Well. Now we fucked. Please don't. A game with already spongy jank, not jank, but like spongy mechanics wasn't designed to be a fucking platformer. They decided to turn it into one. Chief Greenleaf, tier 2, 49 months, welcome back, buddy!
Anyone ever tell you you got a real pretty mouth?
Has anyone ever told you that? That you got a real pretty mouth? Because I'm here to tell you, you got a real pretty mouth. is that suddenly killing me? It wasn't before! See? Like that. Look at that. That doesn't fucking make sense to me. I survived this one. It's only like maybe half a foot shorter drop than the other one. Wait a minute. I was gonna say, I kept going through the same hole again. Fucking idiot. Kept going back through.
Sure, why not? Next stop, sanity.
You're doing well. Keep going.
You're an idiot.
It's hard to make sense of this place.
It's a dream. This is a vast place, home to forces and beings that are completely alien.
The Dark Presence.
Yes. I don't know what happened to it after your final encounter.
Is there any way out of here?
Sometimes transmissions can be sent between worlds. You've done this yourself. But to actually leave the dark place, I haven't found a way.
Stucky's gas station. Not something I particularly wanted to see, but obviously I wasn't the one in the driver's seat.
Another memory made real. Wake would never make it. The insanity he was facing was already a part of it, in him, his own doing. He couldn't possibly win. He didn't even want to.
Open the fucking door.
At least the lighthouse was much closer now. I would have to make my way up there somehow. Stucky's gas station. Not something I particularly wanted to see, but obviously I wasn't the one in the driver's seat.
Another memory made real. Wake would never make it. The insanity he was facing was already a part of it, in him, his own doing. He couldn't possibly win. He didn't even want to.
At least the lighthouse was much closer now. I would have to make my way up there somehow.
Fire.
wire. Oh, I go around, I'm sure. Moving on. There was a Stuckey's gas station in a small town. I was going to say, like, I remember seeing a Stuckey's, but this guy is actually named after somebody in this town named Stuckey. Maybe he's the Stuckey's. Like, the Stuckey of Stuckey's who made the first one and then the franchise. And the name really stuck.
The part of you that is in control is in the cabin, dreaming and insane.
I don't think I like that.
You represent the part of Alan Wake that is capable of rational thought and planning, which is why I'm talking to you. If that part can regain control, then you have a chance of making it. But a part of you wants to give in. There's comfort in the oblivion of dreams. You represent the part that isn't ready to quit and die.
Wait, are you telling me I'm not real?
You're as real as anything else in this place.
So there are two of me?
Yes.
And the one you called Mr. Scratch, he's me as well?
No.
Zane, are you playing some kind of game with me?
I am not the author of your story.
How can you say that when you wrote that page about being the Clicker? It wasn't one of my pages. You directed me to it. You had Weaver guard it.
Yes, she was needed. And you needed the Clicker. But I am not.
What? I don't understand.
Alan, you should keep going.
Zane? Zane, come on!
Well? That cleared things up.
Bye, bitch. Am I going? Let me get my flashlight all the way charged here. Well, his name is Awake. So, yeah, Plever.
The bridge groaned in the unnatural wind. It was heralding the enemy's arrival. Wake wouldn't leave this place alive.
Oh, yes, I will. Yes, huh? Was I low on health or something?
The bridge groaned in the unnatural wind. It was heralding the enemy's arrival. Wake wouldn't leave this place alive.
I can help you here.
What the fuck? Where's this telekinesis? Fucking, where's this been the whole time?
How the hell are you doing that?
Do it on the fucking enemies next time, how about, dickhead?
It's like learning to control your dreams. There's a connection.
You were in my dream.
Yes. I taught you. You fixed the foolish mistake I made with Barbara.
Just picked that fucking giant tree up and twisted it around like it was nothing. Here, let me grab this giant club that I could probably use as a weapon and then just use it as a bridge. I'm not saying you have to swing it fast, just can you drop it on him? No. Why not? Because I am you. You know what? Never mind, bud. Checkpoint at least. Fuck. Oh, wait. No. Fucking stamina meter is fucking terrible. there. Fuck you. There it is. Okay.
Wake ran for the light. It was pointless. He would never reach it.
His Sometimes I dream just as that he is me, he like Mike. If I could be like Mike.
Even with the light gone, all I could do was keep going.
Since we're being so frank here, Alan, and let me just reiterate how happy I am that you had this breakthrough, I would like to summarize your condition.
By all means.
And please, just let me know if you think I'm being...
There is no suggestions for CD Ramathon. Zero APM. You send it to me or nothing.
The car crash.
You have it, you buy it, you send it to me, or you...
All due respect,
or whatever,
Doc Nelson,
but I have plenty.
He's hardly a neurosurgeon. I think that the injury has affected you more than you realize.
Yeah, I do have a UPS box if you want to send it to me.
Then there's your history of substance abuse, which, combined with your chronic insomnia, has resulted in hallucinations and extremely poor impulse control. That's a dangerous combination, one which your wife has unfortunately had to suffer from far more than you.
I know she has.
I don't think I'm exaggerating when I say that you are existing in a state of all-encompassing denial. Your vivid fantasy casts you as a heroic victim and allows you to skirt responsibility for your own actions. It allows you to solve your imaginary problems and dismiss the things that truly trouble you. In your self-serving delusions, your personal problems are assets that allow you to save Alice, perhaps even the world.
Dr. Hartman, I think that's spot on. I can't argue with any of that.
Well, I'm sure I'm stating the obvious. I don't want to labor the point, but, well,
No. I understand. It's important that I face it.
Precisely, Alan. You've put so much effort and imagination into this self-deception, but what good has it really done for you? You refused my offer of help, and here you are. Did being so obdurate really get you to a better place?
No.
No. And did it really help Alice? Was this really the best thing for your wife?
Probably not.
Probably not. Why don't we find out? You know, I've been talking with her. There's something she wanted you to hear.
Oh, hey. That sounds like fun.
Does it?
All I ever wanted was to help you, Alan. I ate all the shit you handed out and tried to understand your pathetic, wealthy white male drama. Until my life consisted of managing your never-ending crisis. I hate you for your childish temper and the arrogance and self-indulgent pride that undermine all efforts to drag you out of the hole you insisted on digging for yourself. I hate you for leaving me in the dark with that insane monster bitch! All you had to do was act like a loving human being for once in your life. life and stay with me. If your dramatic exit hadn't been more important than making sure I was all right, she would never have taken me. I don't know where you went, but that's okay. I don't want to know. I don't think I'll ever be all right. The only thing that keeps me from killing myself is the hope that I'll never see you again.
If this is all in my head, she doesn't really mean that.
Ouch. I just can't argue with that. I think I should stay here before I ruin what life she has left.
I think this is a breakthrough, Alan. I'm really very proud of you.
That's not...
It was nonsense. I knew I had saved her.
Total nonsense.
I succeeded in that, and that was all that mattered. What I heard in there wasn't the truth. It was just another toxic mirage. It cut deep, but that made me all the more determined to force myself to snap out of it. I didn't want to be that guy anymore. I had to make myself see the light.
See the light. I get it. But why male models? I literally just explained that. Thanks, game. It knocked all my shit off the edge. Good job. Is that the PlayStation noise? Why does it focus on the guy that's fucking far away? It's like, hey, there's enemies coming. It's this guy who's a million miles away. Not the guy that's straight up your ass right now. I was almost
well
out of everything.
Done. You have come far, but there's still a little further to go. You must take full control of your own mind. Reject all of the fantasies you have constructed.
Yeah, well, I think I can do that. A lot of the stuff I've seen here is personal and ugly as hell. I'll admit it hurts, but it's not fooling me. I know it's fake.
Good. You are aware.
Good.
The part of you bent on self-destruction is not. But you must be careful. Just because you know the lies for what they are, that doesn't make the danger any less real.
I'll make it. I don't have any choice.
Here. I cannot come any further, but this will help you on your way.
Thanks, I guess.
Hey, let me tell you something, Alan. I know how your mind works. You screw up, then you start analyzing it, and before you know it, you start writing all these horror stories in your head. Don't you?
Come on, I don't do that.
Yes, you do. I know how it goes. You're a complete failure. I hate you and I'll never forgive you for whatever it was that you did. Am I wrong?
Oh, man.
See? I know you. But, Alan, it's all in your head. It is. I love you, and I'm not going anywhere.
They kept coming. There were too many of them. Hordes and hordes of them, swarming over the landscape, eager to kill. They were fucking moving, and this time they would get it with sheer numbers.
There it is.
Checkpoint.
me. That section sucks ass! Nightmare is much different. They get you stun locked, you're just fucked, yeah.
The lighthouse. I was relieved to
awake,
but I wasn't sure what was going to happen now.
That was a fucking suck-ass section, I'll tell you that.
Zane had left me. I wasn't sure what the Dark Presence had done to him if he couldn't follow, but from now on, I was on my own. Still, he had gotten me this far. I would never have made it by myself. This thing was going to end. It wouldn't be long now.
Why'd you spill your beans? Alan Wake. They didn't rename me to Ass Wake. Or, wait. I can do better than that. And there's the island.
I was surprised
by it's at the top of the lighthouse.
But not much.
Of course.
I was starting to understand the symbolism. The way the dark place flowed.
It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right.
Would you rather play Max Payne or watch Major Payne? Oh, man, they're both great. That's a tough choice. That's like Sophie's Choice, man.
Yeah.
It's tough.
Feeling kind of depressed here.
What?
So Zane's your new buddy now. I feel abandoned.
This is ridiculous. You're not even real.
That doesn't mean I don't have any feelings.
Or listen to Lil Wayne. Well, all good, man. They're all good options.
Thing is, you need to get all rational here. Abandon your fantasies, right? Well, I kind of hate to say this, pal, but I'm one.
Fine. You're abandoned. Bye.
That didn't work.
Al, what I'm saying is the only way you're getting in that cabin is through me. It's one of those kill your darlings things. But hell, you're used to that, big shot writer. Am I right?
It was in everything. It was even taking the people Wake knew, turning his friends against him. They were all against him.
What does it say about you? You're this desperate to keep yourself from getting bitter. Here we go! I'm earning the
50% commission!
It's great that you first make yourself an imaginary
friend,
and then you
can't even get along with
that guy. People skills, Al. You're a
master.
Okay.
Let's crack it.
Here's the final battle.
Yours, Alan. You're a
modern
master of crime fiction, an expert on
dark alleys,
and a master of
substance abuse.
That's the
best part.
Think of this as
practical.
You'll make a great
hunting trophy,
my boy! Could we discuss your relationship with
your father?
Uh-oh! Now the Amityville house is coming.
Help! It's great.
And my job
mostly consists of making sure you don't ruin your
entire life because you have all the
impulse control of a
people on track.
It's
very enriching.
I have several
lawyers on
speed dial just because I never know when to
get in trouble again.
You know what kind of people need that? Gangsters.
And assholes.
And you're
not a gangster.
Because they make
money all
the
time.
Hey. When you threw a hissy fit, I your
ego
couldn't take it, and because of that, you
almost got me killed a dozen times over.
BFF, Al!
BFF!
He does sound a little bit like Claptrack, yeah.
It's totally not.
This game is making my dick hard. Hey man, everybody expresses their passions in different ways.
Surly ass.
Come on, damn it.
Driving me nuts.
Okay. got to think about how you just fucked him with a shotgun. How would you not get horny?
It's too dark. Where am I? I can't find my way.
I like your way around other channel sensors.
I can't find my way. It's too dark.
Like, what is he spelling out with the spaces? Oh. Hello, me. Meet the real me.
My mind was clear. Zane had been right. I could think clearly again. But I couldn't survive in this place the way he had.
I can think clearly now, myself is gone.
Leaving this place would be hard. Maybe impossible. It wouldn't take much for my thoughts to stray again. It was too easy to get lost in the dark place. Before, I was ready to curl up and die. Let myself slip away. But here I was. The yet unwritten future waiting to unfold before me. A sequel to Departure. My name is Alan Wake, and I'm a writer.
You fucking did it! Man, two books, like, less than a month, less than, like, a week. Slaith, hey, Slaith, 81 months, somebody, hope you're doing well, literally wearing the same shirt. Have a good day. Oh, you're wearing the same shirt? You got yourself an AGDQ shirt? Hell yeah. Bridge to Part 2, supposedly under development. Really? Interesting. All right. Yeah, AGDQ is coming up pretty soon, right? Yeah, not bad. A lot of fun. That game DLCs, all of it. Very good. Hey, Chronicle! Thank you for gifting a sub to Liceman. Appreciate you. And welcome, Liceman, for the third month. You got your very first stripe there.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that is going to do it for Alan Wake, and I think that's going to do it for me today.